silver or light blue in color. It has no front bumper, and it possibly has wheelchairs in the bed of the pickup truck. What we're needing is for y'all to get this out to all your stations and pleading with anybody. I don't care if they think they saw something, they might have seen something, to please come forward. What happened that we know so far, everything's fluid. It's just that once the pickup truck or Dodge Durango rear-ended another vehicle, that vehicle was pushed through the building, and that's how we got the injuries. Everything else right now is fluid. I can't release much more than that, other than we're at 5 area hospitals right now with 10 to 12 victims. Some are very, very serious, and we'll leave it at that. I'm also making a plea right now. If the person out there did this, is watching this, please turn yourself in. It's not worth it, because we will find you today, and I promise that. Right now, I'd like to introduce Mayor Jacobs, who'd like to say a few words.
Thank you. Thank you. Yes, I just want to reiterate the call for every citizen in Orange County and in Seminole County in this immediate area. If you see a vehicle that fits the description that is driving around without its front bumper, anything suspicious, please immediately call 911. Let us know. We need to make sure that every piece of information comes together. And also, please spend this evening and this afternoon in prayers for the families who have children who have been injured in this absolute tragedy and disaster. Keep them in your prayers, and please keep a lookout and let us know if you see anything. Together, we will find whoever is responsible for this, and those families need to know that this whole community is behind them. God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you. And again, with Mayor Jacobs, the families are in our prayers and thoughts. As we can release more information, we will. We're just asking you to be patient on these kind of situations. It's very fluid and it changes. Trooper Wanda Diaz is the acting public affairs officer right now. She might have a few more things. I don't know if she does, but as she gets things, I will get them to you. Again, get that information out on the hit and run. Thank you.
As they stated earlier, this is a very fluid situation, and we need as much help as possible from the public to find this silver Dodge Durango. It's silver or grayish color. It will have damage to the front bumper. If anybody sees that, please give us a call. You can call us at our station at 407-737-2300. We have 10 to 11 transported to area hospitals. They're all at different hospitals at this time. And as we get more information, as we get confirmation on names and stuff, please be patient with us. We'll release that as soon as possible. Unfortunately, we cannot take any questions at this time. We will be back as soon as we can with more information. And we just ask that you be patient with us. I can't. Like I said, I can't take questions at this time any more than what she just said.
I just need you to repeat it.
I couldn't hear what she had gone over.
You can.
Basically, what we have is one vehicle was struck by another vehicle and sent that second vehicle into the daycare. So we're looking for that first vehicle that did not stay at the scene. This first vehicle struck the second vehicle. The second vehicle went into the daycare. So we're looking for that first vehicle. That silver Dodge Durango. If anybody sees a silver Dodge Durango with front end damage, it's going to have damage to the bumper, please call us at our station. The number is 407-737-2300. We have no confirmation on that yet. Unknown at this time. I don't have that information. We will contact you when we can come back out here with more information. Thank you.